Bach's music was kept alive by his sons, by particularly by the two eldest sons, Wilhelm Friedemann and Carl Philipp Emanuel, who performed many of his pieces in their positions in Halle and Hamburg. The St. Matthew Passion score and original performance parts came into the possession of Carl Philipp Emanuel Bach, who was a musician first in Berlin, later moved to Hamburg as music director. And C.P.E. Bach was always interested in the large works of his father. He studied the B minor Mass, and he apparently also studied the St. Matthew Passion, and must have been fascinated by this music. And wherever he could, he included little sections, little choruses, chorales of the St. Matthew Passion in his own passions. He couldn't perform in Hamburg with a limited number of musicians and limited technical capacities. He couldn't perform the entire piece. This is simply impossible. But I think it should be noted that he tried to keep the music alive to a certain degree. But the big change took only place in the early 19th century. Although Bach's instrumental music, particularly his organ and keyboard works, had been published since the year 1800, and many people knew them and played them, the vocal music by the 1820s was almost entirely forgotten. And I think the brilliant idea of Mendelssohn was to take one of the large, maybe the largest piece, and present them to an audience who were used to a completely different musical style.